We are anxious when we overhear conversations in crowds because, as Brian Ross, who is with us at the moment and has been working this investigation in a very broad way, understand that is about the easiest way to get yourself in trouble.
Overhear
a conversation right. in a crowd. But on the other hand, it sometimes provides very good information. Right. What have you got, Brian?
Well, here is some information that is quite hard. The discovery of the car last night in the Boston airport led FBI agents to a man they have told us was one of the terrorist hijackers, an Egyptian national by the name of Mohammed Atta, who apparently was on the INS watch list. It was Mr. Atta who spent the summer of 2000 in Venice, Florida, with another man, learning how to fly at the Huffman Aviation Service in Venice.
Right, that we've just been talking about.
Yes, and Mr. Dekus was on the line there talking with you. It was Mr. Atta and another man. Atta and this other man briefly stayed with Mr. Decker's accountant, Charles Voss. And Mr. Voss says he threw him out of the house because he didn't like the way he treated his wife.
Right.
As well, Boston continues to be a focus of the activity yesterday. The police chief in Portland, Maine, has told us that five men came across the border in Jackman, Maine. They all tried to board a commuter flight out of Bangor, but there was only room for three of them. The two others went on to Portland. They reportedly boarded a U.S. Air commuter at 5:53 yesterday morning to make the connection in Boston. We're not clear whether it was the connection to the American flight or the United flight, but it's clear that they came in from Canada just before this flight.
I don't know where precisely where Jackman, Maine is, but this is up on the border of, it could be New Brunswick, up on the Canadian border, which is just a part of the world that simply doesn't have, to the best of my knowledge, very much good surveillance on it, does it?
No, they can come across and people go back and forth quite easily there.
What else you've got, Ryan?
That is the latest. The information on Otto, though, is the first solid indication of what FBI authorities have told ABC News is definitely one of the terrorist hijackers who apparently was at least a year ago, learning how to fly at a small airfield in Venice, Florida.
And just one last question for both of you. Do we now believe that in terms of the immediate investigation, the former CIA director James Woolsey pointed out this is not the important investigation if these are the guys who are dead, but that we're talking about 12 people on the four different aircraft in a configuration we don't yet know, but we're talking about 12 individuals about whom they now have some knowledge.
They have some pretty solid leads, in large part because of the information at Portland, and then this dispute that some of them had yesterday at the parking garage in Boston. And the man with whom they had the dispute later called the state police, and that led them to this car, which led them to Mr. Atta. It's, you know, there's a lot for police work, but it's sort of like the traffic stop. This was an argument in a parking garage that gave them a significant lead.
Many thanks. Let me just interrupt you for 1 second, because Lisa Stark, who's in Seattle, has some news about the state of aviation at the moment.